Hello and welcome to pdfsupply.com. Today we're going to be testing an RX3i digital output module. I have here an IC694MDL740. This is a 16-point grouped positive logic 12 to 24 volt DC output. So you can be using 12 volts DC to 24 volts DC, okay? As you can see, I've already have it wired up. My positive lead going from the positive lead from my 24 volt power supply is to the left hand side of the terminal. It's attached to number 1 and number 11. And then I have a jumped lead from my negative terminal, which is connected to on the right hand side of the terminal, number 20 and number 10. All right, and that'll power up both groups. So the first thing that I want to do once I have all the connections established the way that you saw them is go into my software. I'm using Proficy Machine Edition. And the first thing that we're going to do is go to our navigator bar and select the module. I have my rack CHS007. You guys could also be using a 012 or 017. Pretty much any of the racks will work. My power supply is using slots 0 and 1. And my processor is using slots 2 and 3. Same thing, you could pretty much be using any power supply or processor for this test. That leaves me with next available slot number 4. I'm going to right click on that, or you could double click and select add module. Go to discrete output, and we're going to choose the IC694MDL740. Okay, there's a description of it there. Select all right. Now there's no particular settings for this module, but you do want to note where your reference address is so that when you're toggling your bits on in your output table, you know where to start. Okay, so we're going to start at percent output, percent Q 00001. So we want to connect up to the controller once that's all set. Once we've made connection, we're going to hit the green handprint to toggle us to online mode. And now what that means down below, you're going to need to pay attention to this too, is we're in programmer mode. Our outputs are stopped and disabled, or in this case, faulted, which is fine. Configuration is not equal. That's because the processor was handling a different task before we've asked it to test the MDL740. So we're going to go to target, online commands, clear. We're going to clear that fault and the controller and IO fault tables. Okay. Yes. Make sure you do that step, otherwise you're going to get hung up when we go to download and run. So let's go to our download button. Is this download information icon and run button in one, download and start. Now the first thing it's going to ask us, of course, is what exactly do we want to download to the controller? In this particular case, just hardware configuration and motion and logic. Just the top two selections. It's a simple test and we're going to be toggling bits on and off is all. So there's no need to write that to permanent flash memory or force values or anything like that. Okay. Once the build is complete, we're going to go to our output table. It takes about a minute or two to download. Okay, so our outputs are enabled. We're going to go to our default tables. If that's closed, you guys can expand on that, and it'll give you a selection of tables we want output. As I mentioned before, our starting address is going to be in the top right-hand corner, which is... And if I hover this arrow over, you can see it's percent output 00001, right? We're gonna click on that and toggle that on by putting a value of 1 in there and then enter. And we're gonna keep carrying that, turning those bits from a 0 to a 1 until we do all 16, two groups of 8. Now, once we complete putting in all these bits here and turning these values on these particular points, you need to be able to test that there's power going to. And there's three ways to do that we use here. One way is that you can use a multimeter that can detect the 24 volts. Another way is that you can use a light bulb that's set for 24 volts so that every time you probe that particular channel, the light bulb turns on, you can see that the power is there. I'm going to show you guys this really quick. This is just a solenoid, you know, like a relay, and it's activated by 24 volts. So every time I touch a lead that's live, it should give me a clicking sound, okay? It should close the circuit. So I'm attached to my negative lead on the bottom right hand side, and I'm going to touch all my channels. 8 on the top, 8 on the bottom. All right. Next thing that I want to do to make this test thorough is I'm going to put a 0. We know that the outputs are enabled and they're working, but we also need to make sure that they shut off. This is where you're going to find most failures. There's two ways to find failures. One is that if you toggle the bit on and the LED on the user reference on the screen of the actual module itself is not turned on, and there's no power to that particular circuit or channel, then that means that that's not working, obviously. But the other way to check is that when they're all in the off position, they should still remain off. All right, so I'm going to go ahead and probe all my channels, even though they're off. Okay, and these ones are all good. Occasionally, you'll get one that turns on. That means that it's failed in the closed position. You don't want that. That's a problem. Another thing that I usually do when I'm testing that they're in the off position is I just quickly tap my positive probe to my positive lead from the power supply, just to make sure that everything's still working properly and I'm getting an accurate reading. All right. So, just to recap, problems that you'll find with this particular card is you'll turn a channel on and the LED that's associated with that particular channel doesn't turn on, or that it's in the on position, the LED is on but you don't have any power going through it, or it's in the off position and it's technically still on if you touch a probe to it. Okay, any of those things are a card failure and they need replacement or repair. Okay, the MDL740 is a card that we normally repair here at PDF Supply. We offer exchange programs, new and remanufactured products. So if that's something that you need or interests you, please see us at pdfsupply.com. Thank you.